Good afternoon on the third day of InterGeo Virtual. Yeah, my name is Carsten Wieser. I'm from Phase One, and I want to present you a bit of our products for UAV mapping. So how to use the IXM cameras for UAV mapping, and yeah, want to give you a little presentation on that. So just a second to start. Yeah, so Phase One, you know, is a mapping camera, the Phase One camera series, a lot used in manned aircrafts, but also with the IXM series, very often used also in UAV applications. And here we have some is a good arguments to use it and why to use a high quality camera. We are concentrating on the IXM camera series, the small one you see on the left hand side. You will learn much more about in a second. So first of all, let me remind you, especially for the UAV business, there's a lot of small cameras out there which are used, and to remind you that the Phase One camera is a medium format camera with a lot bigger imaging sensor. Yeah, and it is in the imaging, in the sensor technology, it's always better if the pixel is bigger and can collect more light, you have a better result. And here we have both things. So we have a larger sensor, means we maintain a bigger pixel, but also with a large sensor, we can maintain a high resolution with big pixels. And this brings you in the end a better quality. You directly see that in lower noise. So it's more sensitive. You have less noise in shadows. You have a very big dynamic range, so from the lightest areas to the darkest areas, we have more than 83 dB dynamic range, and this means it's 15 f-stops of dynamic range, and you can really afterwards in post-processing open the highlight, bring down the highlights, open the shadows. So if you're balance of image exposure or the contrast in your image is too high, you can balance it and to enable that no blown out areas are in the image, and also that no dark, too dark shadows. So we have a lot of details in there. And this in the end brings a better result and also better measurements furthermore. Yeah, next to the sensor, we have a very good lens system. I start on the lens system here with the shutter system. The shutter system is very reliable, so it's really a professional shutter for high demands of use. So the shutter has a lifespan of minimum 500,000 activations, even up to the shortest shutter speed of 1 to 2,500 of a second. And this brings you the professional tool to do your jobs on a day-to-day basis. It's a very modern system, and we also think unique on the market. It's very modern. It's a direct-driven electromagnetic blades, and we have the whole control above these blades when they're opening and closing. So we can prevent peaks of too high G-forces on these blades so that they are not break, and that we can ensure a long lifespan and not an average of 500 million, a minimum of 500 million, so that you have a camera and a lens shutter system which is built to last. Next to this is very fast. Again, the 1 to 2,500 of a second as the shortest exposure time, but also 3 frames per second continuously can be done with it. To the sensors, let me comment on the sensor technology. We're using CMOS sensor and using mainly them from our privileged partner Sony. And here we use the latest and greatest technology. So we have the backside illuminated structure in our medium format cameras in use. For instance, in the 100 megapixel IXM, you find it. And with this change of the structure, you see on the left-hand side, the front-side illuminated structure, which is dominating the CMOS technology over years. You see that the light passes through a little lens on top of the pixel. Then they have the color filter. We have a little metal wiring, which is an infrastructure which is needed to get out the data out of the photodiode. And the photodiode is the pixel which collects the light. So this is a sensor which collects the lights pixel by pixel. And you see that on the way through this to this metal wiring, there is there's a certain absorption happening so that you not collect the whole amount of light. With the change of what Sony did to flip the structure, the blow structure underneath the lens and the color filter, they changed it to flip it upside down. So the photodiode is illuminated from the backside, and you see that the metal wiring is out of the way, and you collect more light on the same pixel size. And this brings you lower noise, better sensitivity, which in the day-to-day operations helps you to do your jobs even when they are not the best light is present. It also helps you to maintain a short shutter speed while flying fast, so it also gains you productivity. Yeah, the camera we're mainly talking about today is the IXM camera. So this is a medium format camera we built especially for the UAV sector. So it means we try to keep it as small and lightweight as possible. Please remember it's still a medium format camera with a large imaging sensor. In the end, a full equipped camera, fully ready to use, is 1.17 kilograms, so nearly 1.2 kilograms with a lens, with everything. This is very lightweight in the industry. I can make a comparison later on. The camera is IP53 weather protected, so it means it survives any kind of rain, and it's fully dust proof. So also in the environment outside, it helps you to do your emissions. It's reliable. We have a very short, very fast capturing methods. So either you store internally with an exchangeable memory card, we support XQD cards, and even since the last firmware release, also CF Express cards, up to 2 terabytes they are existing, so that you can very fast and storage a lot of data. Or you can also add it to an external little computer, which are also they are getting even smaller and smaller over time. We have some integrators for drones which use small computers that fly next to the drone, and here you also can transfer the data via USB or even 10G Ethernet to other storage devices. So multiple options are possible here. Again, the shutter is very fast, 3 frames per second, and also the sensor delivers this capture speed constantly. This is also very important. A lot of consumer cameras can't do that continuously, so they are very fast in the first 20 frames, but then they slowing down. And if you want to cover a larger area and you want to fly fast and efficient, this might be a handicap. But here we can guarantee 3 frames per second across the mission. Yeah, to the size and weight, I've put in here some comparison. I only compared a medium format camera. So on the left hand side, I would say it's a competition model with 100 megapixel, and this is 2.3 kilograms. Our flagship model, the IXM RS, which we mainly use in manned air aviation, is 1.8 kilograms. It also can be put on bigger drones, and also customers do that. But the drone version you see is even lighter and smaller. It's just 1.17 kilograms, and every grams in weight for the drone is essential to maintain high endurance and long flying hours. Yeah. Or minutes. Page, the range of phase one RSM lenses, which are specially designed for the small IXM camera. We have a range of 5 lenses today, which ranging from 35 to 300 millimeter focal lengths. And these lenses all are made specially for UAV applications. And these applications also when we built the lenses, we sort of best image quality, what we're always looking for, but in addition we also maintain a lightweight design and a small form factor. Yeah, so all these lenses are designed to be as small and lightweight as possible. I would exclude the 300 millimeter here because it's anyway a special lens, but all the others are very small and lightweight compared to the focal lens and what a medium format lens is normally made of. So the 35 millimeter lens, for instance, just 630 grams, so it's very lightweight. And then in the end, you come to 1.17 kilograms for the whole system when using it. The RSM 80 millimeter, you have 2 choices. You can one get the lens fixed focus, so it means it's just set to a certain distance by factory default settings. So normally it's a hyperfocal distance so that you reach infinity and also the closest possible close range focus. But then you can change it anymore. So it's fixed just for mapping flights. The same is, by the way, for the RSM-35, also a fixed focus lens. And then we have two motorized lenses, which we mainly use for inspection, which you can motorized adjust the focus. So with a command from the drone or from the operator console, you can send a command, yes, please focus to a certain distance, and then the focus adapt to that. And also here, it's still a very lightweight, 670 grams, so still very light, and you can control the focus by remote. Yeah, and all the lenses are specially designed, again, for a mapping purpose, so it means they have a very homogenic resolution. So not only the center, the whole field of view is very sharp and crisp, and the resolution is to the corners is not really visible reducing. So you have a very homogenic resolution. Next to this, just want to remind you that also these lenses are weatherproof and dustproof. So that means even when you fly in the rain, which you normally try to prevent, but if it's happening, then the camera is safe to continue to use. Let me show an example for UAV mapping. I've picked here example which we did in Germany on the Zeche Zollern. That was a shootout comparing different kinds of UAV and camera systems, and so it was a good comparison to get an attention or get a knowledge about how is the difference from a normal standard UAV camera to a phase one camera. And this was a project size of nearly 500 by 215 meters. You also see here the display, the area, and then the target GSD for all systems was 1.36 centimeter GSD. The shootout was made in cooperation with the Hochschule Bochum in Germany. So here we see three results from two different I would say commercial cameras on the drone, and then the phase one camera. And first of all, you see that you have a lot difference in terms of field of view, so in coverage on the ground. So with lower resolution and the higher resolution in comparison, we are allowed to fly a lot higher to maintain the same GSD. And this brings in the end, with the high resolution of the sensor, also a larger coverage. So you have more more coverage per image. And this helps you to take less images and even to finish your job of this area faster. Next to this, you can see when you compare the results more in detail that on the 100% level, that you see even when targeting the same GSD of 1.36 centimeters, you see that the real resolution is quite different. Yeah, so it means on the more commercial systems, you lose a bit of quality because of the smaller sensor, in addition to, I would say, a less good performing lens. And watching the 100 megapixel results from the phase one on the same scale, you see that the resolution is much higher, and so you can identify a lot more details on this image. And this also here even bigger result comparison. You really see you get more details, but you also in the end get better measurements out of this. Another example here, here you also can again see the large difference in field of view. So you cover with each image a lot bigger scene, and this helps you to be more productive in your mapping missions. Also here again, a more detailed view to that. It repeats again that you see more details. It's better resolution, even when you're targeting the same resolution in terms of flight altitude and sensor specs. But the real difference is that you get more out of it when using better sensors and better lenses. Here another example, you see on the ground, you see a lot more details and again, get better measurements in the end as well. compare this to different common used camera systems on drones. We have here this example. So I took the two ones from the comparison flight. I added the Sony camera, which is very popular, and also then the Phase 1 camera. And we have here the same area again, the same target GSD, and you see that the image coverage per image is a lot bigger. That means you reduce the number of flight lines that are needed to cover this area. And also you need to reduce the number of images you take for this area. And also you finally reduce the time of your flight. Yeah, so doing all this math and compare it to each other, you see that in the end, the Phase 1 is the most efficient camera. So it is if you take the Sony as 100% efficiency, then it's nearly twice as efficient. So we have 172% of the productivity, and that means you can fly in less time with less images the same area. Yeah, and when you translate this to, I would say, the drone, you know that a certain drone has a certain flight time. So when we now take the example, your drone is able to fly 15 minutes safely. So you have a 50 minutes time frame to collect your imagery. And doing the same math in comparison with the cameras you see here below, I added even more. And then I calculated what is in 15 minutes the area you can cover. And here you see also that you again get a higher efficiency because of the higher resolution sensor. Also the homogenic quality of the image, it helps you also when you really chase for higher GSDs and better accuracies. You might need to fly higher overlap with the sensors over the cameras with a less good quality in the corners of the lenses, because you only can then use the center of the image and might need to fly a higher overlap. But this is not concerned here. So we only use the area of the sensor and the resolution. And what also here you see, that even compared to the same Sony camera with 36 megapixel taking as 100% efficient, if you take the 42 megapixel Sony, it's 18% more efficient. But again, the Phase 1 is then nearly more than twice as efficient. So it means you can fly an area of 810 by 810 meters in the same time, which you normally would for the Sony with 36 megapixel would cover an area of 540 by 540. Yeah, so it means you cover a much more wider scene, and this brings you in the end efficiency, but also it helps you to gain accuracy. As you saw the comparison in image quality, the better the image quality, the better your accuracy. Yeah, summing this up, means in the comparison here, we saw with the same GSD, we had could achieve a larger coverage with the medium format camera. We had less images to take. Also think further for orientating these images in your photogrammetry software. So also the computer needs time to orientate each image. And when you have less images, the time you save here. So also in the post-processing workflow, we will in addition time, so not only for data collection you win time, also for post-processing. And then the shorter flight time you need to cover the same area. And yeah, again, with higher quality on the detail levels, you saw the difference in the images on the ground, on the stones there, on the area, you could identify a lot more details here. In the end, you win a lot in efficiency. Yeah, that's what I want to show you today as a little insight into using IXM cameras for mapping. Appreciate your join, and I hope to see you soon on one of our channels. And if you want to experience the camera and the quality, please get in contact with us on the website, over the sales channels, and we will help you to get you better image quality. Thanks a lot.